Thank you for coming. Can everyone hear me?
Yeah.
Great. This is my first recital for a full live audience since March of 2019. So it's a very special thing to get to do this again and have you both here and on the stream as well. So thank you very much for coming. I'd also like to say how excited I am to be here at Murray State, and also how excited I am to be working with my wonderful colleagues, Dr. Park and Dr. McCann, who you'll see later. The first piece on the program is one of my favorites. This is the Nielsen two fantasy pieces. First one, slow, lyrical thing. And then I'm especially fond of the second movement because it sounds like the oboist has a case of the hiccups. So hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
concerts. And in fact, if someone said, you can only pick one sonata to play forever, and only one, like if I had to make that decision, I think it would be this one. I really do. I keep coming back to it time and again, and every time it means something a little bit different. It's the last complete piece that Poulenc wrote. It was composed in 1962. He passed away unexpectedly the next year, 1963, of a heart attack. And I wonder if he knew, at least on some level, that he himself was close to the end of his life. It's written in memory of Prokofiev. So it's in memory of him that you'll notice the first movement is titled Elegy. And I love this piece because of how intensely emotional and introspective it is. It's very reflective, very contemplative, personal, internal, intimate, vulnerable, all of those things. And really runs the gamut, the full gamut of human emotion. So it's like somebody is close to death or is thinking about death, and these little memories are traveling through as they're reflecting on their life. And some of them are sweet and nostalgic, and then they turn on a quick dime, and it changes to something else, all the way from tender, loving little memories to screaming, angsty, top of my range, anger and angst. And it also is going to push the range of the oboe, extreme lows to extreme highs. Notice also the movement structure is different from what we see in most sonatas. So normally you have a fast, slow, fast structure. This, though, the fast movement is in the middle. Except in the middle of the scherzo, it's like the eye of the hurricane. There's this wonderful slow section that really belongs to the piano there. So my favorite, though, is the third movement. Very, very dark, haunting lament, very chant-like in places. So, hope you enjoy. a favorite of mine. Everything's my favorite, apparently. this piece was composed by William Grant Still in 1942 from the Jim Crow South. And I also am exploring some of his bassoon music, or something that was adapted for bassoon, I should say. He was a trailblazer in many, many areas, a composer, conductor, and a self-taught oboist, among other instruments. He was the first African-American to conduct a major American orchestra, that was the LA Phil, and the first to have a symphony performed by a major orchestra. So this is a wonderfully imaginative little piece that I really I really enjoyed getting to know, and I hope you like it too.
Thank you. lived from 1921 to 1999. And she did all of these things when it was really unusual and quite challenging still for women to be doing any of those things. So she's a trailblazer in every sense of the way and someone that I look up to very much. Brilliant and multi-talented. And the example I love to give about this, March 1945, she performed the Glazunov Piano Concerto on piano, right? And then played English horn in the premiere of her own first symphony. So I first came across her music back in 2016, and back then very few people had even heard of her, at least not in the United States. I suspect she was more well-known in Europe, especially England, of course. But here, people didn't really know. And thankfully, that's really starting to change. So she has a lot of really great pieces in her catalog for all sorts of combinations and lots of wonderful woodwind writing and repertoire. So please do look her up. This trio was premiered in December of 1941 when she was just 20 years old. And it was performed by Marion Bow on oboe. That was Ruth Gipp's friend. And then Ruth's fiance at the time, they married a year later, on clarinet. Robert Baker was his name, and then Ruth Gipps herself on piano. And it has everything that I've come to love about her music. You can hear a lot of lyricism. She kind of shapeshifts from one theme to the next. There's this wonderful sense of storytelling and a little bit of British cheekiness. So I'd like to thank Dr. McCann and Dr. Park for collaborating with me on this, and we will be taking this piece to Colorado this summer at the IDRS, the International Global Reed Society conference this summer in Boulder, Colorado. So this is a little bit of a preview of that. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.